Chapter 814. Amazing Wealth Accumulation Ability. Are you done cultivating in seclusion, Kinlai? Just as he was looking around, a group of people walked towards him from the spatial teleportation formation beneath the platform he was standing on. It was a dozen or so Bloodfiend sect disciples led by Hong Boan. Everyone including Hong Boan was carrying a handful of spatial rings with them. Considering every one of the spatial rings was sparkling with bright light, it was impossible to estimate how much spirit materials had been stored within. Elder Hong, where have you been? Kinlai asked in surprise. We just came back from the ruined lands. Hong Bo smiled freely before ordering the disciples to return to Blood Fiend Sect first. He himself walked over and said, while you were cultivating in seclusion, Blood Fiend Sect used the spatial teleportation formation you helped to create to transport some of our men over to the ruined lands under false identities. The ruined lands' reputation is well deserved. We found all kinds of spirit materials in that place. With enough spirit stones, we can purchase almost all the spirit materials necessary for our cultivation. While they were speaking, the spatial teleportation formation flashed yet again. Then, Fang Rong walked out with a dozen or so blood spear guards with her. She looked to have returned from the rewarding journey too, since the spatial rings on all 10 of her fingers were sparkling with light. Have you returned from the ruined lands too, Instructor Fang? Kinlai called out loudly. Fang Rong looked up toward the tallest point of Flaming Sun Island's grandest palace and smiled. Thanks to you communicating with Evil Infant Boy, we weren't troubled in the slightest when we teleported over to that place. While you were cultivating, both the martial practitioners of Flaming Sun Island and Blood Fiend Sect were able to freely move between the Setting Sun Island and Ruined Lands through this teleportation formation. We were able to purchase a large amount of spirit materials. Hong Bo smiled before sighing. It is only now that I understand why the 9 Great Silver Rank forces hadn't destroyed the Ruined Lands even though they knew of their existence. As it turns out, the Ruined Lands have many evil spirits and passages that connected to auxiliary worlds. There are even more foreign races on the Ruined Lands who came to the Land of Chaos through the Ruined Lands to trade all kinds of resources. Amen. Not only can you buy the spirit materials and spirit stones commonly seen in the Land of Chaos from the Ruined Lands, you can even purchase many rare materials that are available only in auxiliary worlds and secret realms. Even if the 9 Great Silver Rank forces rule over a vast amount of lands, they cannot grow spirit herbs and spirit medicines that can't be grown in spirit realm. Therefore, they can only be purchased from the Ruined Lands, Fang Rong added. So the Ruined Lands can meet most of the demands for spirit materials of Blood Fiend Sect and Flaming Sun Island, right? Kinlai smiled. Most of our cultivation spirit materials can definitely be bought from the Ruined Lands, Hong Bo said while laughing. Fang Rong nodded with a small smile on her face and pointed in Grey Island's direction. Thanks to our wealth of spirit materials, Grey Island's artificers can work non-stop to forge blazing profound bombs. Did you notice how many martial practitioners of the surrounding forces have come over personally to buy them? Flaming Sun Island is literally earning a fortune every day. Hong Boan looked very envious. Alright, I need to go. I need to transport this new batch of spirit materials to Grey Island as soon as possible. Hai is waiting for me. Fang Rong waved her hands, got onto a crystalline war chariot and flew away. Elder Hong, why don't you tell me the general situation of this past month? Kinlai pondered for a moment before taking the initiative to invite him. Hong Boan nodded before jumping from the ground, drawing a bloody river in the sky. About 1,000 meters later, he landed next to Kinlai. A month ago, during that decisive battle, Windbin and Chumiat and Soul Altars were damaged by the 6 strange life forms you released. Hong Boan looked a little awkward and afraid when he spoke of the 6 spirits of Void and Chaos. After Windbin and Chumiat had escaped back to the illusory demon sect, they secluded themselves. They were probably trying to regather the spirit materials necessary to repair their soul altars, and I doubt they were a cover in a short time. During this period, Sect Master Yu is still fighting against the Blue Ghoul race with the elites who are loyal to her. I heard that she isn't doing too well. Kinlai nodded and didn't hurry to interrupt him. He motioned for the old man to continue speaking. Illusory Demon Sect suffered a huge loss and lost over 1,000 elites during that battle. Since Windbin and Chumiat's soul altars were damaged too, it will be a long time before they can gather any strength to attack us again. Of course, we can't attack Windbin and Chumiat right now because they're hiding inside Illusory Demon Sect. Illusory Demon Sect is guarded by a terrifying 3-level soul altar expert after all. Although this person cannot leave Illusory Demon Sect, we will probably lose if we try to attack them. I know. Kinlai smiled coldly. Windbin and Chumiat need time to refine their soul altars, and Illusory Demon Sect needs time to recollect their strength. But the same goes for us. With every passing minute, Senior Zhu fuses with a 7-level soul altar and grows stronger. Perhaps he will be able to use the 2nd level of the Blood Progenitor Soul Altar by the time Windbin comes out. Then, even if Windbin managed to fully recover, he wouldn't gain the upper hand any longer. That's right. Hong Boan laughed loudly. They need time to prepare themselves, but we are the ones who need it even more to gather our strength. 2 or 3 years later, when Windbin and Chumiat have recovered their strength, Big Brother Zhu may be able to use the power inside the 2nd level of the Soul Altar already. In fact, Big Brother Mo Jun may be able to build his 1-level Soul Altar in time too. So Elder Mo's ascension materials have already been prepared? Kinlai asked in concern. Hong Boan nodded and chuckled. Originally, we didn't have enough spirit materials to support his ascension. As you know, Blood Fiend Sect has been struggling for the past 1,000 years, so we don't really have any accumulated resources. However, After the battle against Winbin and Chumiodin, we managed to kill many illusory demon sect martial practitioners and buy some spirit materials with spoils of war. Moreover, Winbin's Wen family isn't on the same continent as the illusory demon sect, so we seized the opportunity to attack them and a few other copper rank forces who had close relations with them. As a result, we managed to earn even more spirit materials. After that, we went to the ruined lands and bought the last of spirit materials necessary for his ascension with the spirit stones we seized. Finally, we were barely able to gather all the spirit materials needed. Unfortunately, that also means that our stash of spirit materials have dried up again. Hong Bowen then smiled and said with a little bit of embarrassment, "We've discussed this predicament with Ms. Song, and we'll be borrowing 1,000,000 Earth-grade spirit stones from Flaming Sun Island. Once we've recovered, we will return the spirit stones and the appropriate interest back to Flaming Sun Island." Kin Lai couldn't help the surprised look on his face. "Ahem, well, Flaming Sun Island is the closest and richest force to us, you know?" Hong Bowen looked a little embarrassed. 3 years ago, when Blood Fiend Sect had gifted Flaming Sun Island, Blood Island, and Grey Island to Kin Lai so that he could relocate his friends, he never imagined that Flaming Sun Island would be able to develop to its current state. The martial practitioners of Blood Fiend Sect had given Flaming Sun Island special care and protection only because they were grateful for everything Kin Lai did for Blood Fiend Sect. They never truly attached any importance to Flaming Sun Island. No one could have predicted that short 3 years later, Flaming Sun Island would possess not only 8 god corpses, but also many Fulfillment Realm and Fragmentation Realm martial practitioners, all thanks to Song Tinu. Blood Spear was also growing swiftly under Lan Zi's command and displaying a shocking liveliness. Of course, what really exceeded Blood Fiend Sect's imagination was Grey Island's ability to gather money. By selling Blazing Profound Bombs, Grey Island had managed to earn millions of Earth-grade spirit stones for Flaming Sun Island. After defeating Illusory Demon Sect and connecting Flaming Sun Island with the ruined lands, Grey Island was finally freed from the predicament of only being able to purchase needed spirit materials through Illusory Demon Sect. During the month Kin Lai had secluded himself in cultivation, Grey Island had forged almost 100 Blazing Profound Bombs. As of that moment, the market price of one Blazing Profound Bomb was 120,000 Earth-grade spirit stones. This meant that Grey Island had earned him almost 10 million Earth-grade spirit stones of clean profit during the month. Even in the past, 10 million Earth-grade spirit stones was a great amount in Blood Fiend Sect's eyes, let alone now. "Your Blood Fiend Sect is asking to borrow money from us?" Kin Lai rubbed his chin with a slightly unnatural look on his face. He really didn't imagine that there would be a day where Blood Fiend Sect would need a favor from Flaming Sun Island. What can we do? Times have changed, and right now Flaming Sun Island's ability to accumulate wealth is practically the greatest in the Land of Chaos. Hong Bowen spread his arms and explained with a wry smile on his face. During the battle a month ago, the dozens of Blazing Profound Bombs that were detonated in unison were so powerful that the explosion killed almost 1,000 Illusory Demon Sect experts in an instant. There were countless pairs of eyes who were paying attention to that battle, and that destructive power made them realize just how important the Blazing Profound Bombs truly were. This is especially true for the forces who haven't been annihilated by the three ghoul races yet. There is no one who doesn't want such a destructive item by their side to turn the tides in their favor. In the Land of Chaos, the Terminator Profound Bomb is the only other weapon that possesses similar destructive power. Unfortunately, Terminator Sect doesn't have many Terminator Profound Bombs, and they aren't easy to refine. They lack artificers to forge sufficient number of Terminator Profound Bombs, so naturally they have no reason to sell them to outsiders. That is why the Blazing Profound Bombs price wouldn't stop rising. Kin Lai listened quietly and nodded thoughtfully at his words. Right now, Flaming Sun Island already possesses a sizable amount of wealth. Thanks to Ms. Song's operations and recruiting of talents, many martial practitioners of small forces had joined you to form the foundation of a big force. Hong Bowen pondered for a moment before continuing seriously. Right now, the only thing Flaming Sun Island lacks is Nirvana Realm and Imperishable Realm experts. If you can get one or two Imperishable Realm experts to guard Flaming Sun Island, and recruit a couple more Nirvana Realm experts, then Flaming Sun Island will be able to break through its limits and evolve into a Silver Rank force. Kin Lai was emotionally moved. The Silver Rank forces of the Land of Chaos are not the only ones who possess Soul Altar experts. You should know that there are many Soul Altar experts at the Ruined Lands too. Of course, since the people there are all evildoers, they are not accepted by Orthodox forces. Hong Bowen continued. Aside from them, the 7 hidden experts are also altar experts as well. Even better, they possess 2-level or 3-level soul alters. They are a force to be reckoned with. The 7 hidden experts? Kin Lai looked startled. Hit a couple more Nirvana Realm experts, then Flaming Sun Island will be able to break through its limits and evolve into a Silver Rank force. Kin Lai was emotionally moved. The Silver Rank forces of the Land of Chaos are not the only ones who possess soul altar experts. You should know that there are many soul altar experts at the Ruined Lands too. Of course, since the people there are all evildoers, they are not accepted by Orthodox forces. Hong Bowen continued, aside from them, the 7 hidden experts are also altar experts as well. Even better, they possess 2-level or 3-level soul alters. They are a force to be reckoned with. The 7 hidden experts? Kin Lai looked startled.